Today we're building another replica engine, a pretty special engine if I would say so myself. It's a 6-liter V12 that's making between 720 and 850 horsepower. I'm of course talking about the AMG Mercedes M158 engine. It's a twin turbocharged monster of an engine. It's a single cam though, which I highly doubt, but as of course the reports I found state it's a single cam, I don't really know. If you have more knowledge than I do about these types of engines, do let me know down below, and also while you're down there, do let me know what engine you would like to see on the channel. I will see if I can make that happen. If I can't, I will let you know. But anyway, thank you to the commenter who suggested this wonderful engine. We're going to try and stick to the original idea, but if we can't, we will make a plan. Of course, that's just how it works. What I find really fascinating about this engine and the chassis it came in, it came in all the Pagani huayras up to recent, which is pretty crazy, and also it came in Mercedes AMG SL65 Black Series. If you don't know that car, please go research that thing. It's an animal of a car. It is a V12 front engine rear wheel drive car. I find that particular part really crazy because you don't get many front engine V12 cars anymore, especially not rear wheel drive. That's all my knowledge. Let's get back to this engine build. It's looking pretty crazy. So far as I know, this thing is making good power for its size. It's making 2,200 horsepower now. It's doing pretty good, but I see we have a lot of red flags still, which exhaust, turbine, valves, intake manifold is still not terrible, but it can be better. The intercooler and of course the compressor. I think we might have to switch to bigger turbos, or rather more turbos in this case, because we're already on the biggest we can get, keeping a somewhat usable rev range. Let's see if we go variable. No, no variable today. Okay, more boost. Okay, so I'm gonna see how far it can go before it really starts making a problem for itself. I mean, close to 3000 horsepower, the spring lifter tension doesn't really do anything. So I think it's time we switch. There we go. 3145 horsepower is absolutely phenomenal. The only problem we have now is the header size, but that is being solved really quickly. Let's see. Can we do a little more trickery to get a little more rev range? Yeah, okay, we can't do too much. So that's pretty good. And 3.1 bar boost. It's really starting to push this engine a little harder. Adding some more boost, doing a little more trickery to make it go even better. 3,500 horsepower looks pretty easy. We might have to revisit this engine sometime, because I feel we've not done it justice that much. We might have to do a part 2, so do let me know down below if you'd like to see that. Maybe one on nitro meth with a little more boost and a little more crazy. I think that would be a pretty interesting engine. But let's see. I think there we're pretty much tapped out. Oh yeah, I forgot that. Okay, I'm gonna leave it there. That's pretty good power. So let's go see what this thing sounds like. Look at this beauty. It's big and it demands your respect. Anyway, we're gonna do two dyno runs. One looking at the engine, one looking at the graph. Let's see what this thing sounds like. I do think it's gonna be a pretty good sound. V12s will continually sound better and better no matter how many times I build one. But anyways guys, that's all from me for today. First of all, thank you if you've stayed to this part of the video. Second of all, hit that subscribe button. I've got a feeling you might like it around here. But anyways guys, that's all from me for today. Enjoy the rest of your day. Bye bye.